playing up against his former team. He is all over it.
Set right back in that time by Keller. Took a whack from Lucic.
Well, he'll take it. Absolutely assist Rittich. It even happens at this level. The dump in by Clayton Keller. Rittich gets it. Where's he going? Where's he going? A goaltender throwing it right up the gut of the ice. Stepan picks it off. Drops it. Bangs it into the back of the net. One Cobb Coyotes. His third of the season.
Maybe that's going to get Derek Stepan going. How do you get it to Frost? Wasn't there. Cleared all the way down.
Giroux tried to break his stick in half after that pass attempt to Morgan Frost. Very frustrated.
What happened here? And they score! Gostis, Barrett, Hart got their signals crossed. Duclair scores. And it's a 2-2 game.
Wow. What a turn of events here. And Duclair is a speedy guy. He gets in on the forecheck. Carter Hart casually looking for someone to give that puck to. Believes he's going to shield it from Duclair and give it to Gostisbehere. And Duclair wraps it around. It actually goes off the pad of Carter Hart and through his legs. We got a 2-2 game.
Taves puts it into an area in front of the penalty boxes. Lee dumps it in and takes a hard hit from Ben Chiarot.
Now those two got something.
Bailey the steal, and Nelson taps it in. Josh Bailey took it away from Carey Price. And the Islanders finally have one.
Yeah, a good offensive play as Anders Lee starts it all off, takes a hit from Chiarot, just dumps it in, and the Islanders go to work on the forecheck. And Josh Bailey gets in there and steals the puck. And Brock Nelson has an easy goal. There's a simple play. Get it in deep and now get in on the forecheck. Price has got it behind the net. Waits a little too long. Bailey takes it off of Price. And Price gives up his shutout on his own fault, his own mistake. And that seems like the only way the Islanders have been able to score.
Line across for Pasternak. Swing and a miss. Krug's rocket goes into Sissons. He bolts it ahead. Here comes Halak. Yossi out. He scores! Two goals in a span of 35 seconds, and the Nashville Predators have come from behind to lead the Bruins.
What? Talk to Kevin Dean. They say they play a lot of man-on-man. They don't really play layers in their own zone. And even though Yossi, that's not his man, the shot block frees that puck up into the neutral zone. He just takes off. Halak has to make the decision. He makes it, he comes out, but he can't get the pass past Yossi. Yossi able to play with the body. And how about that pivot? As that loose puck.
He enters the line. The lanky defenseman will get there and get it back.
Oh, he loses it, and Farabee scores! Joel Farabee says thank you very much. It's 3-1 Philadelphia.
Tonight as well, Ristolainen might rethink this the next game. Putting it back to Carter Hutton. Hutton decided he was just going to gently throw it back into the corner to Ristolainen, and Joel Farabee. I mean, how easy was this? Oh my gracious!
I pinpointed the 5-hole, Bill.
That was a 55-hole. Oh man!
Social media and the news that's coming in, breaking every minute from around the world. And there's the first goal of the game. Edmonton Oilers' Tyler Ennis early in the second.
And it's Yamamoto coming on the one side. He gets in the way of Hellebuck. He can't control it. Scheifele a little late reaction. And Yamamoto gets his stick in there. There's a bouncing puck. Tries to make a play around his own man. Yamamoto to the front. And look at Ennis.
And Kapanen gets the puck. Lifts it in the air to center. A race for it. Mikheyev straight up the middle. Howard couldn't get it. Mikheyev scores. Ilya Mikheyev with a goal 30 seconds left in the second period, and the Maple Leafs have gone ahead 2-1.
And Mikheyev's getting the fist bumps, but how about at the other end, maybe a little tap for the goaltender. Good job of Freddie Anderson just holding his ground. Didn't go down early, able to make that play. A long dump in pass that just using the speed. We said earlier, Mikheyev using his speed so effectively, he just got inside, he won this battle, and that's one of those decisions. A quick one for Howard. He was late in making it, and just a real good patient read by Mikheyev.
If you're in a wide stance, makes it awfully difficult to get moving.
Oh, and Frick score! Ovechkin! A bad bounce off the board, 6:93. Ninth all time.
Well, you can't get a much easier goal right there, as this one bounces off the goaltender. Soros couldn't tell whether it was right off the wall, but he just collects it and jams it in from the goal mouth.
And Hughes wires it in. Fleury cutting it off, turned it over. Forsberg scores. Well, Marc-Andre Fleury got himself in trouble there, and he paid the price. He turned it over behind the net. Philip Forsberg picked it off, tucks it in. The Predators, with two goals in a span of 144 and three goals in the period, are up 4-2.
It started with an early goal, and they've just built off of their third here, not even 10 minutes into this game, as Fleury trying to play this over to Theodore. Great read by Forsberg, and he just walks out from behind the net and puts it past Fleury, who's diving back, but not in time. And the Predators.
The Canes get to it. Little scoop by Nages, not out. Held in again by Tyler Ennis. Mrazek misplays it. Shutout has been broken. At the side of the goal was Colin White on a loose play. He cashes in off his backhand after Mrazek misplayed it.
15 shots. Sometimes you want to get out and do things to make yourself still feel involved in the game, like getting to the end boards on this wraparound. Hits the heel of Peter's stick.
A couple of times with some stick checks, and now Vatanen out to center. Morgan Geekie refines the handle. He'll dump it in.
I gotta wonder why the, oh boy.
Look out, they score! The Canes jump on it. A loose play for Nino Niederreiter. Gift wrapped. And Carolina cuts the lead in half.
A nightmare. Right, this is a nightmare for the Bruins. They seem to be in complete control. The whiffed in, Rick shoot in, and then Halak with this failed attempt to clear, and a goaltender's nightmare, Brian.
Yeah, just trying to do too much, and he had his head down. He didn't see Niederreiter there. The play was to just give it to McAvoy in the corner. And once he got it to his forehand, it was almost like he set his mind up that he wanted to fire that puck. If he just would have kept it on his backhand, dumped it to McAvoy.